So the Supreme Court is saying boundaries between judiciary and parliament contested for a long time. Court is being called to establish democratic values floor test on the 27th. So that's tomorrow. Breaking news. The floor test has been announced for the 27th. That is tomorrow. So that breaking news coming in that the decision has been for a floor test tomorrow. So this has been the demand of the parties, the so-called sort of opposition parties, the coalition, and the Supreme Court seems to have agreed to hold the floor test on the 27th. This is going to be seen as a setback to the BJP, which has been asking for a floor test at a later date. They're saying that there should be flexibility. But floor test on the 27th. Arvind Gunasekar, over to you. What? Give us more details.
Vasu, Supreme Court has agreed with the argument of the petitioner, that is Shiv Sena, Congress and also NCP, and they have ordered that floor test should be conducted tomorrow, that is 27th November. The court has also said that all the MLAs should be given oath, that oath-taking ceremony should be held before 5 p.m., after which the floor test should be held tomorrow. So this is a big, big order from the Supreme Court, where the Supreme Court has rejected the argument of the Chief Minister, also from the Governor office, where they said that Governor satisfied with the number of MLAs he has given vote to. He has made Devendra Fadnavis Chief Minister. Now the Supreme Court has said that the floor test should be held immediately. The floor test will be held tomorrow after 5 p.m. By 5 p.m., all the MLAs should be given oath, after which the floor test will be held.
And also, Arvind, what we're hearing is that the court has also ordered that the floor test should be videographed. So in a sense, they've agreed with almost all the demands made by the petitioners. Arvind.
Yeah, Vasu, not just that, the court has also said that the pro tem speaker will be chairing the floor test. In fact, he said the court has said that the pro tem speaker will be administering the oath for the MLAs, after which he would be chairing the floor test. In fact, what was the argument by the Chief Minister and also Deputy Chief Minister? They said that only the speaker can be allowed to conduct the floor test. The pro tem speaker should not be allowed to conduct the floor test. Even that particular argument by the Chief Minister Devendra Fadnavis has been rejected by the Supreme Court. Supreme Court has said that floor test will be chaired by the pro tem speaker. Pro tem speaker will administer the oath for MLAs, after which the floor test will be held, and that particular floor test will be videographed and the results will be submitted to the court. So again, a big victory for the petitioners. Whatever they have asked, Supreme Court has agreed to all their contentions, and then they have passed this order. Vasu?
Okay, so here are the big breaking news points coming from the Supreme Court, which virtually ticks all the boxes that were demanded by the petitioners. That is, in this case, the Congress, the NCP and the Shiv Sena. Floor test within 24 hours. So the floor test is going to be tomorrow. It will be a temporary speaker, what is called the pro tem speaker, who will administer the oath. There will be no secret ballot, and the entire proceedings is going to be videographed. Arvind, so this is virtually, as I said, this ticks almost all the boxes that were demanded by the petitioners.
Yeah, also, in fact, this secret ballot rejection is also very important, because even in the Karnataka case, the parties, the petitioner parties, they were arguing, saying that there should not be a secret ballot, because once a secret ballot comes in, so people will not get to know who is voting for them, who is voting for which side. So they oppose the secret ballot also. Even this time, Supreme Court has gone with the past precedent. They have asked the pro tem speaker to chair the floor test. They have said that it should be videographed. They have also said that it's not a secret ballot. It should be a open voting. So it's pretty much clear. Whatever demanded by all these parties have been agreed by the Supreme Court, and Supreme Court is not going into the legal issue whether the governor was right or wrong, but they have said that the only way to prove whether the party holds a majority or not is a floor test on the floor of the house, and that's why Supreme Court has ordered the immediate floor test, and the floor test will be held tomorrow after 5 p.m. once all the MLAs are given oath.